Good morning. Myself Dr. Ritesh Kumar Saraswat, Assistant Professor in EC Department of MLB Textile and Engineering College, Bhilwara. In continuation of previous lecture of PCM, Delta Modulation, Adaptive Delta Modulation, and today we will discuss about the Differential Pulse Code Modulation. In DPCM, the sample of a signal does not change fastly, that is, its present sample to next sample does not change by large amount. The adjacent sample of signal M of T carry the same information with little difference. When these samples are encoded, the resulting encoded signal will contain redundant information. As shown in given figure, the signal M of T is sampled by flat top sampling at interval TS, 2TS, 3TS up to 10TS. The samples are encoded by using 3-bit or 7-level PCM. The sample is quantized to nearest digital level from 0000 to 111. 0000027, there are the 8 samples. 0 related to 000 3 bits and 7 related to 111 3 bits. By observing the figure, sample taken at 4TS and 5TS are encoded to the same value of 111. This information can be carried only by one sample, but these two samples are carrying the same information, means it is redundant. If considered samples at 9TS and 10TS, difference between these samples is only due to last bits, and first two bits are redundant since they do not change. Next, consider the DPC section. In DPCM transmitter section, it is working on the principle of prediction. It will consist of section, quantizer, encoder, and prediction filter. Sample input is given to the summer, which is connected to the quantizer. Quantizer output is given to the summer, and another EQF NTS is given to encoder. And encoder is provided the DPCM signal. The output of quantizer is given to another summer, which is connected with the prediction filter, and the prediction filter output, that is the M cap of NTS, is given to the first one summer. And the first one summer basically working as a comparator. Because of that, one input is positive, another input is negative, so this is provided the difference between the M of NTS and the M cap of NTS. It is known as the E of NTS, error of the sampled input and prediction filter output. The predictive value may not be exact, but it is very close to the actual sample value. The sample signal is denoted by the M of NTS, and predicted signal is denoted by the M cap of NTS. The difference between them is known as the error, and it is denoted by the E, capital E of NTS. E of NTS is the M of NTS minus M cap of NTS. The predicted sample value is produced by using a prediction filter. The quantizer output EQ of NTS and previous prediction is added and given to the prediction filter. This makes the prediction more and more close to the actual sample value. So the quantized error signal EQ of NTS is very small and can be encoded by using a small number of bits. Thus, number of bits per sample will be reduced in DPCM system as compared to PCM system. Next section or PPT will show the DPCM receiver. From this figure, there are the two sections. First one is the section decoder section, another section is the prediction filter section. Firstly, the decoder reconstructs the quantized error signal from the incoming binary signal. The prediction filter output and quantized error signal are summing to provide the quantized version of the original signal. Thus, the signal at the receiver will be differ from the actual signal by quantization error Q of NTS. Next PPT will represent the comparison of various digital pulse modulation technique. There are the various parameter, number of bits, level or step size, quantization error or distortion, bandwidth, transmission channel bandwidth, SNR, complexity of system, area of application. So when first one parameter, consider the number of bits in PCM, it can be used 4, 8, 16 bits per sample. In DM, it use only 1 bit per sample. In ADM, it is also used only 1 bit is encoded for the sample. And DPCM, bits can be more than 1 bit but are less than PCM system. Next one parameter is level or step size. The number in case of PCM, the number of level depends upon number of bits and step size is fixed. In case of DM, step size is also fixed. In ADM, according to the signal variation or the slope of the modulating signal, step size is varying accordingly. In DPCM, fixed number of level are used. Third one parameter is the quantization error and distortion. In case of PCM, it depends number of level used. In DM, slope overload, distortion and granular noise is present. In case of ADM, quantization error is present. And the DPCM, slope overload, distortion and quantization noise is present. Fourth one parameter is bandwidth of transmission channel. In case of PCM, highest bandwidth because number of bits are higher. In case of DM, lowest bandwidth is required. Similar in ADM, lowest bandwidth is required. In DPCM, bandwidth required is lower than PCM system. Next one parameter is SNR. In case of PCM, it is good. DM is poor. ADM better than as compared to delta modulator. And DPCM, it is fair. Next one parameter is complexity of the system. In case of PCM, system is complex. In case of DM, simple. ADM simple. And DPCM, it is simple. Area of application. In case of PCM, audio and video telephony. In DM, speech and images. ADM is also speech and images. And DPCM, speech and video. Next one PPT or slide represent the PCM-TDM system. This system is using many codec as shown in figure. The codec is basically a PCM encoder, that is known as the transmitter, and decoder, that is also known as the receiver. Codec will generate a serial stream of PCM data. At the receiver side, codec receives serial PCM data and generate an analog signal. The sampling frequency of PCM can be selected by external clock which is given to the codec. One codec per channel is using in PCM-TDM system. The output from various codec are combined and multiplexed into single bit stream by using multiplexer. The bit stream is converted into baseband waveform by using line waveform generator. The low pass filter is using for band limit of baseband signal. At receiver side, the waveform regenerator is used to construct the input noise waveform to clear digital signal. It is given to demultiplexer, which is firstly for detection of individual signal, channel signal and separate them. The codec then recover the analog output signal. There are the way input signal is given to various codec. These codec signal are given to multiplexer. Next given to line waveform generator. All the signal or the codec PCM signal are given to the single line passing through the low pass filter. This is the first one section is the transmitter section. Next below one is the receiver section where the input is low pass filter given to pulse generator, and next demultiplexer. Demultiplexer just similar reciprocal of the multiplexer where the input is single, output is multiple. Where the output is provided the codec 1 signal, codec 2 signal up to codec n analog signal. So that's the working is known as the PCM-TDM system. Thank you.